everyone. My name is Andrea, together with my colleague Alina, and under the supervision of Estefania, we have performed a review study of deep learning for scene recognition techniques. First of all, what is scene recognition? In computer vision, it refers to identifying a scene or a place that is depicted within an image. It is a complex, non-trivial task, especially when given distinct scenes that have similar features. An example of this would be differentiating between a bedroom and a hotel room. Scene recognition is relevant and can be applied to various fields. Some examples of this include food scene recognition and classification of from first-person perspective images, cultural event recognition, and more recently, indoor localization of mobile robots. In order to approach the task of scene recognition, we need to consider how scenes are defined. We can look at them using two complementary aspects. First, we have semantic features, meaning the objects, activities, and other high-level information of what is occurring in the scene. And then we have contextual clues, which include the background itself, textures, and related colors of the environment that are captured within the image. We've already established that scene recognition is non-trivial, but which are the related challenges? There are two main challenges, and the first one is high interclass variance. In the image that you see, each row showcases images belonging to the same class. In the first row, we have the kitchen class, and although all of these images depict different kitchens, they are vastly different in appearance, so it becomes difficult to find similarities within images belonging to the same class. The second challenge is low interclass variance, meaning images from distinct classes, in this example, baseball field and baseball stadium, that are very similar to one another, therefore there is no clear-cut distinction between the two classes. The most common approach to tackle such challenges comes in the form of deep learning. Deep learning for scene recognition has been enabled by the availability of very large data sets. As an example, we have the Places database that contains 10 million images and 365 scene categories, some of which you can see in the image on the right. CNNs can be trained on such a data set, directly learning contextual clues from the images. Without such a vast taxonomy of scenes, it would have been impossible to properly train deep networks for such a complex problem. In our review paper, we differentiate between two types of scene recognition. On the one hand, we identify static scenes depicted by single images, and on the other hand, we have dynamic scenes which are generally captured by videos. The approach to static scene recognition is generally combining places and objects CNNs, whereas for dynamic scene recognition, an extra step is imposed in order to tackle the temporal aspect. This temporal aspect may introduce distortion, noise, or camera motion. One novel approach for static scene recognition is creating a scaled hybrid CNN model. Given the initial image, image patches are cropped, starting from small scales up until when the entire image is considered. And the reasoning behind such an approach is the fact that smaller scale images mainly contain objects, meaning semantic information, while larger scales also include contextual clues. Therefore, we can apply different networks depending on the scale. Either a pre-trained scene CNN or a pre-trained object CNN can be applied depending on the explained contents of the patches based on the scale. The extracted patch features are then combined, resulting into a multi-scale feature per image, which provides us with the final classification for the given scene. For dynamic scenes, the temporal aspect of the scenes must be considered. Therefore, a temporal residual network is proposed, TRESnet. A stream of images that capture temporal effects on the scene. including camera motion that we have to account for as it adds extra noise, is passed as input to the PRS90 network. This network has to handle this distortion in the form of noise or camera motion, which is a challenge specific to dynamic scenes. Finally, the network provides the final classification in the form of a scene label that describes the input video. The potential of the state-of-the-art CNNs reported in our paper can be easily seen if we quantify the obtained results. As an example, we can take the hybrid CNN that was presented previously. Implemented using 7 different scales, this CNN obtained a 94% classification accuracy on the same dataset on which a human expert could attain only 70% accuracy. This clearly indicates that the complexity of the CNN models can capture very detailed information, managing to outperform even the human experts. Some discussion points that we have identified within our research is, for static scenes, deeper networks can become noisy, so increasing the complexity does not always necessarily achieve better results. The training data plays a crucial role as well, as training on more categories leads to increased results, and it can help the network predict more labels, as we have seen with the places database. Also, pre-trained networks on the places database can be used for object classification, not only scene classification. This is due to the fact that the intermediate layers of the networks can also detect semantic information. For dynamic scene recognition, the research is still in its incipient phase. However, it can be shown that dynamic scene recognition can be achieved by adapting networks used for single image analysis and making them take into consideration the temporal factor that is involved and can handle distortion. Moreover, the transformation does not require a very large training set in order for the network to obtain good results, as we have seen that a limited set can also perform well. That was a quick summary of our study. Thank you for your attention. If you are interested, you can find more information about scene recognition in our paper. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to contact us.